And then the Johnny's magazines, of course. I have Duet with NYC Boys on here. And News and Arashi and Kanjani 8. Here's Kanjani. And Potato is a really good one. This has Tegomasu in it. Wink Up is my favorite, though. This is Wink Up, and this is Kanjani. And I have a poster over there for Kanjani. And then this is Kanjani. Okay, so I'm going to get into some books that I really like for learning Japanese. This is Essential Japanese Kanji Characters, like 250. And this I really like because there, you can get a lot of kanji textbooks, but this one I think covers ones that you need to know, like basic ones, and not just, it doesn't go in a weird order, it just kind of, it has really practical things in here, so if you like it, it's, I like it. This one is kind of harder to find. I think I found it on White Rabbit Press, but they have it in about 10 different languages. This one is English, Thai, Indonesian, and Vietnamese, but they have like Korean and all sorts of languages. And it's called ストーリで覚える漢字, and then this is like 300 of them. So it teaches you the stories behind the kanji, and then like you go back and learn the like the way to pronounce them, and then it gives you quizzes and stuff. It's really good. I like it. This is my Japanese textbook that I used for the past year in school, and it's for 300 level in college. And it's called 上級への扉. And it's humongous. It's huge. It's really heavy. And it has passages and then vocab. The chapters are like 20 pages long. And you start out with like, 本文を読む前に, and then you go into like this huge thing of just Japanese, and then you have kanji and all that stuff. It's really good, but sometimes they teach you things that I don't feel like I would ever use. Flashcards, and I really like White Rabbit Press flashcards. Oh yeah, I didn't show you guys. This is Taeyang, the Hot Tour DVD. Also, I have lots of manga. I have all of Body. I have Ultoman. I have novels in Japanese, and I really like Koizora, so I bought Koizora in Japanese. And usually in Japan, they don't like reading big books like we do. Like, if you see someone carrying, like, a huge Harry Potter book, it's no big deal. But in Japan, they like smaller things that they can just kind of put in their bag and read on the train. So these are smaller, so they break them into the one and two, and they're really pretty, though. And then this one has a little thing about the movie on there. And I have some novels, and then I have manga that I've collected. I don't read as much manga. I read mainly shoujo. And if you guys want to see my passport holder, it's really cute. It's Hello Kitty. Like, has my passport in here. And, like, it can hold my little ticket and everything. If you guys know about Japanese deco, this is, like, deco, and, like, somebody made this for me. And then I made this one. It's, like, when I take purikura, these little, my little stickers things, my purikura of, like, me and my host family and stuff like that. I just decoed my little notebook. This is my little bag for my Japanese yen. And you guys have probably seen Japanese yen before. But there's one. And I have everything in here. The ones that have holes are 5 and 50. Can't really see. There you go. Also, I have, like, random pins for G-Dragon from Big Bang. And I have a lot of stuff like that. And then I have a news calendar, and I have a calendar for You're Beautiful, the Korean drama, and stuff like that. They just kind of sit up. So I guess basically that's most of my fangirl stuff. I have a lot more magazines and books and things. I have one more book that if you are more advanced Japanese, the book that I really like is called Read Real Japanese, and it comes with a little CD, and it doesn't give you translations. It gives you a dictionary in the back, and it gives you the story, and then like it on this side, it'll give you like little phrases that you might not know how they should be translated or how to read them, but they won't actually put the English next to the Japanese, which I think is nicer because especially if you're upper level, you need to kind of learn reading skills, and I feel like if I was just given the English that I wouldn't try as hard to read. So if you guys want to see anything else, just let me know, but that's pretty much all that's in my room at the moment. When I go to Japan, I'll probably get tons more Johnny stuff and stuff like that, but I think I'm gonna probably make a video after I know a little bit more. I'll probably make another video when I'm almost to Japan, like when I have my visa. I don't have my visa yet, and I don't know my housing situation yet. But, so I think I'll update you guys a little bit later. But for right now, just keep asking me questions and leaving me comments, and I'll get back to you whenever I can. Thanks for watching, guys!